everyone, it's Nona Grace, and I'm from Western New York. Before I start this video, I want to show you I finished another doll. So now I have three rainbow dolls. And I've got a fourth one I'm working on. It's going to be a white one, but I haven't decided what color dress I'll put on her. And these are so addictive, these little dolls. They're fun to make. And I've get a lot of questions as to what I do with these. Well, the kids play with these, and I plan to try to put them on Facebook. My daughter said I shouldn't put it on Marketplace, but I should put it on the local, just on my page, because too many people ask too many crazy questions. And I don't want to mail any of these. I want them all to just come to the house and pick it up. And if I put it on my page, then it will be people that I know that would be able to pick it up. It would be more local people. There are a few people that are on my page that are not local. But if you can't come to the house and pick it up, I guess you just can't buy a doll. So that's how I plan to sell them. I don't want to monkey around with the postage and handling and that stuff. I don't want to do that. I don't like to leave the house as it is, and that would mean I'd have to for sure leave the house and do... I don't even have it on Facebook because it sounds like such a chore. Everything sounds like a chore. I don't feel like doing it. And so, because I don't feel like doing it, it sounds like a chore. I used that cabbage that we cooked. I didn't show you how I made it, but I did put the cabbage together, and what I did is I scrambled up some Hamburg. I can tell you what I did instead of show you. And those of you that know how to cook can cook. Those of you that don't, well, watch a few cooking shows and you'll learn. But I scrambled up some Hamburg and I cooked up the cabbage. I did like a German cooked cabbage. I just put it in the frying pan and just kind of sauteed it. And I put garlic because I don't have it. I don't have any onions in the house, actually. I have to buy more onions and chop them up and put them in the freezer because we don't use onions often enough. But I put garlic powder in there and I put
thyme.
Yes. I put a tablespoon of garlic and a tablespoon of thyme. And Jim comes down and says, "Oh, that smells so good." I couldn't smell anything. I go, and then Jessica came in and she says, "What are you cooking? It smells really good." I'm glad they could smell it because I sure can't smell it. I can't smell anything yet. But I put that in there, and then I put eggplant in it. I have eggplant that I have froze from other years, and I had sweet peppers and hot peppers. I put tomato sauce, and I put salsa, but the tomato sauce is the big jar of tomato sauce, not the little can of tomato sauce. It's the spaghetti sauce is what I put in there. And a jar of the salsa. I like salsa in mine. And then I put a teaspoon of cayenne pepper also. And Jessica goes, "Ooh, this is a little spicy." And I go, "Yes, it is. We make everything spicy." So it was really very, very good. It was like a little stew. And you could put that over pasta, which is, I did cook up a little bit of noodles for myself. I used the Ramus noodles is what I did, and I cooked them up, but I really prefer it with real macaroni versus those. Those are okay, but they were just quick, and I used half a package. I didn't cook the whole package, which I could eat the whole package, and the eggplant in it is really good, and the peppers, because I didn't roast the peppers first and take the skin off. The skin does kind of roll up a little bit. In fact, Jessica wanted to know what it was, and I said, "That's the skin off the pepper." That's why when they char them a little bit to get the skin off, that's why they do that, so that you don't find skin in your food, or pepper skins.
Pepper skins.
Not skin. Yeah. Well, I hope you all had a great day. I got, how many days did I say that? 14. I got a 14 dozen.
14 or 15?
No, I got 15, I think.
15, because you got three and the one doesn't finish the one. And then
I did a whole dozen. So when I put my eggs out on Tuesday, I had a question about that too. What do I do with all these eggs? Have I ever froze any or dehydrated any? No, I have eggs all year round. I don't need to do that. But I sell the eggs in the spring. I've already been putting them out and people buy the eggs. And in the winter, I give a lot of eggs away because I still get quite a few eggs in the winter, even though the hens are supposed to slow down. Mine slow down, but they still keep giving me, and because I've got 20 hens, I get quite a few. I think I have 3 broody hens again. I think Emma's one of them, Little Lady, and the Mean Girl. So I'm not sure what I'm going to do. I'm going to be going away pretty soon, so I can't let them get broody, hatch out chicks, because I have to take care of the chicks. I can't expect Emily to do that. It's easier for me to do it than for her to do it. And if you have to check the eggs under Mean Girl, it's a lot easier for me to do it. I know she's going to bite, and Emily, I'm sure, she's a little bit of afraid of the chickens, I think, to begin with. And then if they're going to bite you, she would really be afraid to try to get the egg out from under her. So I don't know what I'm going to do with her. I don't want her to hatch out babies, because her babies will probably have her personality. You know how they say kids have the same personality as their parents? Well, I don't want mean babies. That's why I like Emma to hatch out. She's a very good mama, and she's a nice bird besides. And Little Lady, she would be a good mama too. She's a gentle bird. Mm-hmm. Well, I hope you all had a great day, and I'm done chattering.
What about your video?
What? I forgot to put that in. Oh, good heavens. We better put that in before I forget all about it completely.
You did so much work on it.
Oh, I know it. Those of you that do those motorcycle videos, I give you a lot of credit. It's not easy to cut down and to decide what you want to put in. So let's just go to the video and you can see what I'm talking about. Forget.
Yep.
Oh dear. Well, I hope you enjoyed the music that I put with that video. And it went in fast speed all by itself. Jim's GoPro does it, and he doesn't even know how it does it, but it seems to do it. But I said it's okay because it helped me cut a lot out. I cut probably what you saw was only a fraction of what really was. I cut an awful lot out, but I think you get the gist of it. He traveled the trails, and he traveled in the, he brought, what it is we can go from our house all the way to Ryan's house without really being on the main road, as you saw. But there's a lot of mud puddles. We've had a lot of rain, and there's still more rain to come. Well, I hope you had a great day, and you had a warm day if you want warm day, cool day if you have a hot day. I had a cold day, but it was not bad. Jim didn't think it was bad. He rode the bike, and Ryan rode his four-wheeler. It's all fixed, and he got to take it home. Well, have a great night, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.